Tuesday's Storm Team Forecast with Chief Meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
What advantage of all that rain, it kind of, got things a little soggy. So this is Paul Jones in Hampton Township, Cumberland County, rolling things around and kind of leveling out his lawn there in Hampton Township today. A good day to get out and do a little mowing, but we're not completely done with the rain. You can see live on our York Sky Cam some blue. You also see some of those clouds with a little bit of gray in them, yeah, and there have been a few showers around right now. York's at 72, very comfortable, too, with a dew point at 50, a light westerly breeze. That breeze is going to die on down this evening. We could still see an isolated shower. I'll point those out for you another hour or so, and then I think they'll start clearing on out. We'll drop down into the 50s this evening overnight. A little cool, mid-40s tomorrow. Not a bad day. Not quite as warm as today. I think we'll be in the mid-60s. We'll call it partly sunny. But again, one of those pop-up showers in just very isolated neighborhoods tomorrow afternoon. Majority tomorrow, majority of us stay dry for tomorrow. Here are some of the local streams and creeks. Still at the action stage in Lancaster on the Conestoga. The only warning is at the Soterra Creek at Hershey, but everybody else coming below the banks. And there's that warning for the Soterra in Hershey. There were a few showers in and around the radar scope. You can see them now down into parts of York County. A few of those heavier showers are now moving out of Lancaster County, moving over toward Cockringville, New London, and parts of Chester County. But they just pop up, very isolated. You can see them kind of coming on through. Here's another few more just east of Gettysburg, heading over toward Hanover right now. Again, these are very light showers, and I think they're going to head on out of here next hour or so. Temperatures, though, all of us seeing temperatures right near that 70-degree mark. See on the satellite, there's a little kind of a line with this these clouds. It's that front that we showed you to our west, still kind of weak and just kind of meandering right on through. Here's that upper-level storm just sitting back over the Great Lakes right now. It's just kind of drifting along, but it's lost a lot of its punch. So nothing real severe, nothing real heavy with these showers. Predictor shows them just kind of dying off. We drop through the 50s as we clear out and then down into the 40s overnight tonight. Tomorrow looks like a good day. We'll get back up into the 60s. Again, we can't rule out a stray shower, but I think tomorrow's pretty dry. Looks like after a cool morning on Saturday, it's a little better chance with a weak front of a few more showers, but I wouldn't cancel any plans. Saturday we may get up into the 60s to near 70 degrees. But another cool one on Sunday. Again, that pop-up shower, just enough instability. Monday looks dry. Tuesday, maybe a shower or two. I'm not real high on those chances. But again, it doesn't look real warm. I do think the second half of next week gets a little bit milder. We should get back into the 70s. I think we could even warm up toward the end of next week.
I was surprised last night, kind of when there was a break in the showers, it was a little warm out, actually.
Well, that warm front came through, and that's what really gave us the heavy rains, the warm front. Yeah. The cold front still trying to make it
interesting.
Through
Joe said it was going to do that.
Well, he was exactly right.
That's why we listen to him. Let's listen to Julie Gargatta now for a look at the roads. Julie?
Hi there, guys. You know